Hi, my name is Maria Ducatez, and I'm working at the National Institute for Agriculture, Food and the Environment in France. For the last 20 years, I dedicated my work to the research on avian influenza. Avian influenza, particularly the H5 subtype, is of important concern as it affects both domestic and wild birds. But this virus can cross species barriers, posing a threat to mammals and occasionally even to humans. Its rapid spread can cause severe illness and mortality in infected animals, thereby affecting food security and biodiversity, but also posing potential risks to human health. As a consequence, avian influenza is listed as a priority disease by the major global authorities overseeing animal and human health. It is therefore crucial to study and closely monitor H5 viruses to anticipate and effectively respond to disease outbreaks. Avian influenza is a virus that possesses unique characteristics. This virus undergoes constant evolution, which relies on two distinct mechanisms. During its replication within infected cells, mutations occur in the genetic material of the virus. This leads to minor genetic variations. Additionally, this virus can exchange genetic material or gene segments with other influenza viruses infecting the same hosts, leading to the emergence of brand new strains. These mechanisms enable the virus to adapt and escape the immune response of its hosts and potentially become a danger to other species as well. Avian influenza originates in regions where poultry farms interact closely with wild bird habitats, especially aquatic birds, which are the natural reservoirs of this virus. The highly pathogenic H5 strain was first detected in a poultry farm in China in 1996. Since then, it has spread to wild birds, giving rise to new variants found worldwide. Transmission pathways for avian influenza include direct contact between infected and non-infected birds. Contamination of surfaces such as water, mud, or dust can facilitate transmission. Recently, aerosol contamination, or in other words, transmission through the air over short distances, has been recognized as a potential route. Importantly, some infected wild birds may not display symptoms, but remain capable of spreading the virus over long distances. During migration seasons, wild birds have played a pivotal role in transporting avian flu across regions and continents. The H5 strain is now endemic in wild birds and has been identified on 5 continents. As of 2024, Antarctica has also been affected, with only Oceania remaining free from this virus. Birds, both domestic and wild, are primarily affected by avian influenza. Domestic chickens often exhibit respiratory difficulties, reduced egg production, nervous symptoms, and high mortality rates. Initially, ducks acted as a reservoir without showing symptoms. However, recent strains of the H5 virus, particularly those that emerged in the 2020, have led to significant mortality in wild birds. These strains have also spread to shorebird colonies where dense populations gather, resulting in thousands of deaths. Various mammals can contract the virus by ingesting infected birds, leading to infections in at least 26 mammal species so far. The US have recently confirmed cases of H5 in dairy cows. The disease is also associated with huge economic losses through poultry death and the necessity to implement control measures in infected farms. Currently, the disease spread is controlled by culling all birds of an infected farm. Since the H5 strain emerged, over 500 million farmed birds have been slaughtered, with wild birds' death estimated in the millions. The EU started a vaccination program in late 2023 to get the infection numbers down. In WiliMan-ID, we explore various factors regarding this disease. We characterize the variants of both recent and older H5 strains, as well as assess the host susceptibility for infection. Our primary focus is on understanding the transmission dynamics between domestic and wild bird populations and evaluating the associated transmission risks in mammals. We use a multiple scale approach to study avian influenza viruses. Our research begins with surveillance of viruses circulating in Europe. Samples are collected from sick or dead animals, and the complete genetic profile of the virus is obtained. Knowing the genetic sequence enables us to monitor viral evolution. This enables us to see if evolving strains represent an increased risk to both birds and mammals. Using cell culture from different hosts, we investigate the virus' ability to replicate. Additionally, these cell cultures also allow us to identify key host factors involved in the infection response, such as immune response mechanisms. Finally, we also conduct experiments to monitor the efficacy of control tools against avian influenza viruses, such as vaccination. This includes assessing vaccine effectiveness against new variants. We also develop methods to determine when vaccine updates are necessary to match currently circulating strains. Avian influenza will remain a threat to birds and mammals. With WiliMan-ID, we are able to create the knowledge that helps us monitor and try to keep this constant threat under control.